Okay, well, nice to see you all, or at least to be in contact, to be in touch with all of you. So as mentioned by Mark, it's the 10th International Abinit Developer Workshop. And of course, many of you know what is an Abinit Developer Workshop usually. Many of you know also the Abinit project, but let's come back in time with respect to this Abinit project. Perhaps not of all know the following, that actually Abinit was started in 1997, and actually it was a pioneer for these two ideas that I presenting here, that software applications for first principle simulations were becoming more and more sophisticated, and one needed a worldwide collaboration of specialized and complementary groups. And in order to do this, we decided to adopt the Linux software development model, which is a free software model. And we were actually quickly followed by several other software projects throughout the world. There had been already some commercial software projects, but we were the first to be immediately going into the idea of free software. And well, this was very successful. 24 years after, there are more than 2,500 registered people on the forum. The number of lines of Fortran 90 is more than 1,100,000 lines of code. And to give a size of the community of developer, there has been about 60 contributors to Abinit version 8. Of course, many contributors only contributed some little addition to Abinit, but there is nevertheless a large number of people who have gone inside the Abinit sources. There was actually a precursor to Abinit. There are still lines from the Corning Planewave code inside the current Abinit, because this Corning Planewave code was actually commercialized between 92 and 95 by BioSim. But actually, it was not a very great success. And the person that was in charge of the development of the Corning Planewave code decided to give the free green light to something completely opposite to a commercialized code. That's why we started the open source adventure of Abinit. So as I mentioned, 97, beginning of the Abinit project. In December 2000, the release of Abinit version 3 under the general public license. And then we had indeed 10 international Abinit developer workshop between November 2002 and May 2021, between 35 and 60 participants each. We launched the forum in January 2010, and so with more than 2,000 people registered on the forum, this is kind of a nice impact in the community. This is the picture taken at the previous Louvain-la-Neuve International Abinit Developer Workshop. We will try to have a kind of a group picture this afternoon. Let's see how it will work through everybody turning on his camera. We will see. Okay, at the level of the evolution of Abinit, I usually give some indicators of what is happening, numbered indicators. You see between 2004 and 2021 with the different versions of Abinit, the number of automatic tests has been steadily climbing. Now we are at 1,320 automatic tests. The number of thousands of lines of Fortran 90 has been also increasing, with some jump here. The size of the package has been also evolving. Sometimes there is some cleaning, and that's why it is a bit more chaotic. And at the level of the number of 490 files, there has been an increase, but actually we have realized that this was not the good way because it was much better to use modules in 490. And we made a big modularization modification of Abinit that lasted something like 4 years in order to decrease the number of files and have a better structured and better usage of 490 capabilities. And so we are at present and 857 files. It is important to also emphasize that over the last 4, 5, 6 years, there has been many developments based on Python in the so-called library AbiPy. And at present, the gallery is a collection of 59 plotting scripts that proves to be very, very useful, also giving connections with Jupyter notebook. And it's very nice to see users using more and more these features of AbiPy, the nice prolongation of an electronic structure Fortran code with script and visualization capabilities. Also noticeable, there are 44 tutorials in the Abinit package. Now at the level of the bibliometry, we have published altogether 5 articles co-authored by all active developers of Abinit. The first one was in 2002. The last one was last year, just at the time of the a bit after the developer workshop 2020. There are a couple of these papers that are very widely cited, this one with 2,500 citations, and of course this one also with nearly 2,000. The more recent publications still have to acquire their number of citations. They are still very heavily cited nowadays. Actually, Abinit is definitely not the most used first retrieval software nowadays. I would call it a medium with respect to the usage of some other first principle software. It is much less used than VASP, Gaussian, as well as several others, but it is also much more used than many other electronic structure code. So it is a well-established code. Marini take it as a reference, allowing to do good science with also some interesting specificities. And this is actually something that has been highlighted in still another paper by many authors of many contributors to Abinit, also published last year. Abinit overview and focus on selected capabilities, in which indeed we have kind of highlighted these capabilities of Abinit that might not be present in many other electronic structure code. Of course, the list here is not exhaustive, but dynamical mean field theory is present in Abinit. GW plus PAW is also present. These might be present in one or perhaps two at most electronic structure code, but not many. There are many advanced capabilities of Abinit in density functional perturbation theory. Let me name a few. The strain perturbation, I think it's completely unique in the field. The spin magnetic field perturbation likely also. Flexoelectricity is unique. Dynamical quadrupoles is also unique. We will hear about these at this workshop. The nonlinear electric susceptibility and Raman intensity are also quite important in the Abinit capabilities. Positron lifetime, the T-DEP, temperature dependent electronic structure capabilities, and then the electron phonon, which are quite developed in Abinit, zero point normalization, mobility calculations. From what I get from people discussing about Abinit, the quality of the documentation is especially strong, and especially also the tutorial. Not many, well, very few codes have such nice tutorial to guide the beginners. The AbiPy script gallery also is something very noticeable. And then while this has been possibly a real difficulty with Abinit in the past, well, from 2000 to 2014, where we did not have really good pseudopotential libraries or PAW atomic dataset libraries, the situation has been completely reversed thanks to the to two different initiatives, the Pseudo Dojo, as well as the Jolet GTH PAW atomic database. Okay, so the Abinit workshop is a well-established series of workshop, but of course, what we have usually at these developer workshops are presentation by developers, but also external invitees, and there will be some external invitees also. Sometimes expert users make some a presentation. We usually have a poster session and attendance by developers, confirmed developers, but not only. There are also newcomers. Young developers, future developers are usually participating, also are invited, because it's nice to see the Abinit developer community. Even more important than presentations and the poster session, we have usually a lot of discussions about technicalities, about shaping the future of Abinit, about improving experience of users, brainstorming about most needed improvement. These are usually done by small group discussions, etc. And moreover, we have informal discussions at coffee breaks, meal times, evenings, excursions, but this year it's not possible. And I'm deeply saddened about this impossibility to have such usual informal discussion, that when you know people are packed in the same place, naturally people discuss and enjoy being together. So we will keep the discussions time, definitely. But we have also decided to start a new activity. We will see how it will go, the online interaction with users. You have seen this on program. May I invite all of you to participate to these interactions? Initially, it was thought that we would have a lot of questions to answer from users. It's apparently, it will be more simply discussing with users, presenting each other, seeing what users are interested in. So do not hesitate to participate to the sessions on Tuesday, 1st June at 10 and Friday, 4th of June at 10 also. But this is in morning Belgian time, well, Paris time also. And this is at 10 evening in Paris time. So for the 2021 Abinit Developer Workshop, we have 28, apparently here I had the number of 27 registered participants to the poster, to the workshop, 40 speakers and no posters. This is also why we have so many speakers. We thought it would be better to allow everybody who wants to make a contribution to have a small contribution. And we have 35 users registered to the Developer Meet users, and already 16 developers have said that they would participate. There will be 4 sessions in parallel. It is split over 2 days. So we likely will have between 5 and 10 users in each session with a couple of developers as well. Okay. So yes, best wishes to all for this unusual 2021 edition of the workshop. And I hope we will have nevertheless a very nice group picture for all the participants.